Hi everyone. Today in this video, I will show you how to mirror for support, and I will also show you how to support this some easy rings. You know, like most of the rings you will support this way, but some rings, of course, it's really different. So let's check it out. So I will just take our model again, and from the beginning I will show you. So this was our test model. Let's drag it and open file. So we took the model. As you remember before, you know, the other lessons, the top perspective, right and front view. So now we will come to perspective and we will use render. I mean, you can choose which, whatever you want. There are options here. But for me, the rendered is easier way. So I come to perspective and this is your model. This is some simple ring. So when you come to front, this is exactly aligned, probably aligned. This is for aligning, as you can understand in the name. And we press C, concentrate, and we press 0. So right now, as you see, this is exactly the middle, it will be in the 0. So what we were doing before lessons, what we showed, first we have to put this one 3 mm high, right? So let's hold it and let's press shift and let's put like this 3 mm high. So why this is actually, this align, why it's important? Because the thing is, sometimes in the rings it can be bangle, it can be other stuff also, there are symmetrical parts. So while when you are making it, it will be really helping you. If you align the model, you can mirror easily, or maybe you can use arrow polar command. So it's better to use aligned model if it's better to support it. So let's get started. So this is our model. When we come to perspective, so we have right now 3 mm higher this model. So this kind of rings, it is not all rings, but this kind of rings usually, first we let's enter our command and let's choose our mesh, press enter, and as you see, there were options from the last class, you can remember. We will use 1-point endpoint for this kind of rings. We will also show you actually the other type, like it's better not to put 1-point endpoint or change the angle. And what we were doing, let's come to front view and first let's choose the radius. I will choose for this 0.6, let's say. Shift. When you press shift, it will be like, you know, 90 degree only. Like it will, usually it can be like this, but when you press shift, it will be directly like this. So let's choose this, okay, this line. So in this line, it's asking to until where you want first point. I want till here, let's say, okay. So once you did it, check it, okay, check it. So you see it's not passing anywhere, it is good. Okay, and now endpoint time. So this radius 0.6 was for this line. So now we will choose it point, let's say 3. Okay, now we will put the endpoints. So you can put one by one, one here, one here, one here, like that. You can put it, but I will show you mirror. So let's put one here, okay, and let's put also one here, and actually let's put also one here, okay. The important part is here, is it touching or not? Okay, it's not touching, it is good. If it would touch, we had to support different way, okay. And I will show you the mirror. So mirror, as you can understand, it will mirror it, the support, from one line. So what we are doing, we will choose this support and this support. Okay, so we will basically mirror from here to this side. So we first enter our command mirror, and it says the mirror plane, you know, the line where from where you want to mirror it. So we choose zero. So it can make the zero line. Why I told you, you know, in the beginning, why aligning is important. It's important because of this kind of stuff. So right now you did it and it is not stable. Press shift and it will make exactly 90 degrees mirrored. Press OK. So now, as you see, it mirrors. And let's do same with this one. Let's mirror it. And zero. Okay. And again, shift. This time, we want to mirror this side, so we want to make it here. Okay. And we press again zero and we press shift. As you see, it is really easy. It is really easy. And I want to put also one here and one here, or even depends on the model, if the rings are big or something, you can put even two, you know. And let's put bass support again, but this time I will put 1 point because I want from this point till zero. So I choose 1 point. I want, let's say, 0.4 this time. You can also choose, actually, for example, you chose radius 0.4, right? Check it here. Let's say you want thicker, so let's make it 0.5. Okay, so you see it's thicker. And what I will do, I will put, let's say, one here. And now I want to mirror it. But which lane I want to mirror? This lane. So I choose it. I press mirror. I enter the command. And I press 0, and you see, look, it will be like this. When you press shift, it will be directly from this plane. So it's done. And for the casting and stuff, if you wanna add something, I can show you. You can add this diameter like this and come to front view. In front view, I want to put some here like this. Okay, and let's come to perspective. I mean, it's okay. So now I will, this is, but this is, as you see here, one surface edit. You have to make it mesh, this one. So let's come mesh from NURBS object and says okay. So now we have surface. Right now still we choose surface, and okay, you see here created a mesh with 2145 points and 2048 polygons. So right now we selected surface still, so delete this one, and you see this one is mesh. So let's say you wanna move it, you can also move it like this. Let's say put a little bit here, or sorry, let's put a little bit here. Okay, you can play with it. So actually right now this model is ready. Thank you for watching. So as you see, I showed you how to support and some extra stuff also, mirror as well. So hopefully next video I'm gonna show you surface. I mean the surface we are putting from top view, why it's important, how we are using, and the logic of it. And I will show you the logic of the support. Thank you again.